episode! Welcome to Count to 99! I'm Sean Bradley.
Koji です!
So today we are going to be doing a special episode where we take a look at attending events in Japan, how to buy tickets, how to get to the venues, how to find your seats, how to talk to the wrestlers after the show, pretty much everything you need to do to survive an event in Japan. First of all, we're going to talk about some events that we attended recently. That's why we haven't made a video in a couple of weeks, because Koji went to Nagoya for WIP Queendom, and I went to Yokohama for Tokyo Joshi Pro. So we're going to tell you a little bit about those events, our experiences, so you can get a feel for how things work here in Japan. Koji, you went to WIP Queendom recently, so tell us about Queendom.
うん、はい、私が行ってきたのは WIP クイーンダムって言って、日本のアイドル AKB48 がプロレスをやっているという、大会がありまして、それの2回目の興行が、名古屋でありましたので、そちらに行ってきました。チケットの方は、一番高い席種で3万円っていう、まあ、すごく、日本の大会では高い、大会なんですけど、まあ、アイドルがプロレスをするという、少し、変わった、大会なので、まあ、その分少し値段が高いというものになってます。うん、私が買ったのは、スペシャルリングサイドの席で1万5000円高いですね、はい、うんうん、の、席でいました。まあここは大阪になるので名古屋までの移動が、まあ、1万円ぐらいかな、新幹線で、片道、かかってで、見るという形になります。あと、まあ、グッズの方は、まあ、パンフレットとか、まあ、T シャツとかね、あのいろいろあるんですけど、私は、このパンフレットをね買ってきました。こちらは1000円と大変お安くなっておりまして、なかなかいろいろな、プロレスのね、この WIP っていう、団体の、選手の紹介であったり、試合の紹介であったりっていうのが、載ってある、パンフレットになります。大会自体は、どうだろうな、まあ全部でこれ何試合あったのかな、7試合、うん、全部で7試合あって、トータルの時間とすれば約3時間ぐらいかなぐらいの、大会になりまして、非常に、まあ、アイドルが、やるプロレスではありますけども、非常にボリュームがある大会でございました。もちろん、まあ、いろんな試合があったんですけども、僕の一番のベストマッチ、ベストバウトは、セミファイナルの6メンタグマッチかな、その試合が、すごく、面白かったですね。でまあ、なかなかちょっと見る機会がない大会なので、非常に私としては、まあ、面白かった大会だったなと思います。
WIP is kind of special because it's off branch of Tofu Pro Wrestling, which was a TV drama here in Japan. Was this the second?
Second, I think.
So this is the second time they've done this, and it's been overly successful, so I think they're going to continue each year, so this is one of the events that you can go to when you come to Japan. The event that I went to was in Yokohama. It was for Tokyo Joshi Pro, and it wasn't a kind of major event or anything. It was just a standard pay-per-view that was streamed live. My ticket was quite cheap, 4,500 yen for just a standard seat. I didn't want ringside or any kind of special ringside. We'll talk more later on about the different types of tickets you can buy, which will make more sense then. On the way from Osaka to Tokyo and kind of Yokohama area, I took the night bus. Now, the night bus, there are many types of night bus, sure, and it really depends how much you want to spend. So I was just looking for the cheapest way to get from Osaka to Yokohama, and the cheapest one I could find was 4,000 yen. Now, when you put that in comparison to the Shinkansen, like for Koji, for example, to get to Nagoya, that was 10,000. So the night bus all the way to Tokyo for 4,000 yen is a steal. But with that comes the cheap seats, and it was literally kind of like this, shoulder to shoulder. I had some other guy next to me, and he was kind of falling asleep like this. And I was, ugh, all the way, and the trip was maybe about 9 hours or so. So it's a long time and it's a very kind of small space. So if you're looking for comfort, I wouldn't recommend the night bus. However, there are night buses where you can pay more, maybe 8,000, 9,000 yen, where you will get an individual seat and you can kind of stretch your legs out, and then a private curtain. But if you're paying 8,000, 9,000, you may as well pay the extra and just take the Shinkansen. So it's all about your budget really and how much comfort you want to get for your money as well. At the show, the main reason I was there was for the main event, Maho Kurune versus Miyu Yamashita for the title. That was a great match because that was the first time I'd ever seen that kind of hardcore style in Tokyo Joshi Pro. It was the first time I'd actually seen a chair used as well, which was quite interesting. So for me, that was definitely worth the travel all the way from Osaka and traveling back as well. Coming back from Yokohama, I decided that I didn't want to do the night bus two times because it was just so draining. So I ended up getting the Shinkansen back. The Shinkansen from Tokyo to Osaka will probably cost you about 15,000 yen. Okay, so first of all, we'll kind of give you a quick explanation of the different types of seats that you can buy. Now, these all vary from promotion to promotion. I think, well, you can see on some of the posters here, there are different kind of tiers starting from the cheapest going all the way up to the most expensive. Usually, the cheapest ticket is for under 18s, lady seats and that type of thing. There are usually about three or four tiers going up in kind of rank order. Usually the cheaper seats are labeled as C and B. And then A is where it starts to get a little bit more expensive because you're getting closer and closer to the ring. So Koji, can you tell us about the other types of seats?
まあ一番リングに近いシートが、まあよく言われるのが、まあニュージャパンであればロイヤルシート、まあ他の団体とかであれば、例えば VIP のシートとか、あとは S シートって呼ばれる、ところがあります。で、その次のブラックが特別リングサイド、まあスペシャルリングサイドなので SRS と呼ばれるものに、なって、その次がリングサイドなので RS というシートの大体3段階ぐらいかな、3タイプなる形が、まあ、アリーナの席種になりますね。
I posted on Reddit and Twitter and I asked you guys to send in your questions to us so we can kind of help you guys understand what goes on in Japanese events. So the first question comes from a user on Reddit called 123Reddit. He said, I went to many shows in JapanAnd had a lot of trouble finding my seats. Koji, how do you find the area?
Nihon はちょっと変わってるのかな。日本は、まあ使う会場がいろいろあるので、まあ統一されてるのはリングをセンターにして、北なのか。東なのか西なのか南なのかというまず4方角を決めてるんですね。これ多分アメリカとかはセクションなのかな。だから日本はまず4方向というものに分けて、北のブロックの、どのシートの何列目、東の、ロイヤルシートの2列目みたいなの、10番みたいな形の、席になるので、まず方角を探すところから、始めてください。
The next question comes from Reddit user Kamataki, I think it's pronounced. He asked the question about the various fan clubs in Japan. Not so much how to join them, but if they're actually worth the money and what do they get for being a part of the fan club. So Koji, what can you tell us about Japanese fan clubs?、
日本のファンクラブは結構ありますね。各団体にあって年会費かな、1年でいくらかという形になって、だいたい4000円5000円ぐらいかな、年会費を払うことで、ファンクラブに入ってファンクラブの、特典を受けることができます。ファンクラブに入ると何ができるかっていうと、まあ、チケットの、先行 販売であったりとか、
うん、
まあ、撮影会かな、
うんうんうん、
あのその大会に、撮影会こう選手がこの大会はこの選手の撮影会がありますので、うん、ファンクラブの方は、その撮影会に参加できますとか、あとは、ファンクラブ限定のイベントとか、まあ、そういったことの特典が受けれるようになったりします。
So the next two questions are kind of similar、we got a question from Reddit user LeeConway92 and Prospect2 on Reddit, and both of these people were asking about coming to Japan, especially for Wrestle Kingdom, how to get to Wrestle Kingdom, where Wrestle Kingdom is, and just talking a little bit about that. Now, I've never been to Wrestle Kingdom, shocking, I know, but Koji has been to Wrestle Kingdom many times, so he's the expert. So Koji, tell us about Wrestle Kingdom, how to get there, and so on.
Hi.レッスルキングダムというのは新日本プロレスの年間最大ビッグマッチであります。で、これはもう毎年場所と、日にちは決まってます。あのレッスルマニアみたいにこう、うん、あの場所が変わるとか日にちが変わるということはなくて、新日本の場合レッスルキングダムは決まってます。場所は東京ドーム、そして、日にちは1月4日で、これも決まってます。なので、もう場所と日にちが決まっているので、そこに、まあ、皆さんスケジュールを合わせていただくという形になります。なので1月の大会になるので、チケットは前の年の10月ぐらいから発売されるという形になります。
The next question comes from Twitter user Lewis C. So he tweeted to me and said, I thought about this since Lucha has been moving to the US Indies a lot, and there's a tradition of throwing money at the performance, and that's kind of moved with it. Twitch has also added tipping for certain wrestlers and so on, and he was wondering how that would go down in other countries. Well, in Japan, there is no tipping culture. If you have an amazing meal, or you know, you have a great time at a bar or whatever, you don't need to leave a tip.I made the mistake once of leaving a tip the first time I came to Japan, and the staff actually chased me down the road and said, Oh, sumimasen, 200円. I was like, oh, no, it's a tip. And it just, yeah, it doesn't work here. So as much as you want to kind of leave a tip or whatever, that isn't a sign of appreciation really here in Japan. As far as it goes, it shows. So I guess in Lucha, like the throwing money thing,Again, we don't have that in Japan, but what we do have in Japan, you've probably seen it a lot on Twitter and other videos, is kamitepu.
Kamitepu.
Yeah. Koji, what is kamitepu? Can you describe and explain?
これ日本の独特の文化ですね。いつから始まったのか正直私も分かりません。
Yeah,
うん、いつの間にか選手がリングコールされるときに、ファンの皆様が紙テープを投げるという文化が定着していて、で、まあ、時代の変化とともにその紙テープの色もね、変わっていく。その選手のイメージカラーに対してそのイメージのカラーの紙テープを投げるという形で、その紙テープの文化も進化していって、カラーバリエーションもいろいろなカラーがあって、もう最近ではシルバーだゴールドだね、
うん
う
ん、
もうあの少しあの高価な紙テープまで出てきているというのが今の、日本の紙テープのね、文化があります。まあ、ただ全部の団体が OK というわけではなくて、ニュージャパンとかは昔紙テープが OK だったんですけど、もう今は紙テープは禁止になっていたり、OK と NG の団体があるので、まあ、そこはちょっと気をつけていただいてという形になります。
If you wanted to join inwith the throwing of the paper tape, you can buy a roll of kind of paper tape from any kind of stationery store, but because the way it's sold is very, very loose, so obviously if you throw that, it's going to probably injure someone. So what you have to do, using like two toothpicks is the best way, grab the center of the roll and then twist and twist and twist and twist until it becomes like obviously a lot tighter.That gives it a little bit more weight, so you can kind of get it up into the ring, but also it kind of unravels faster, which is gives it that very nice kind of trail as it flies through the air. Be aware, sometimes the ceiling is quite low on some venues, so there will be kind of lighting rigs at the top, but again, there will be an announcement to say, When you throw your paper tape, please make sure you're not throwing it up into the air because it will get hooked onto the lighting rigs. So make sure you're throwing the paper tape kind of up and over the ring, but not so high that it's going to hit the lighting fixtures. So try practicing at home throwing your own paper tape and make sure you get that kind of angle right. Okay, so we just mentioned about some of the announcements that you might get at the show. So what we're going to do now, Koji is going to pretend to be a ring announcer, and he's going to say some of these phrases that you might hear at the shows, and then we're going to talk about what they mean. Koji, can you try the first announcement
in this one? 30分, 一本勝負を行います.
Okay, Koji, how about this one?
60分, 一本勝負を行います.
Okay, so could you tell the difference there? Yeah, the difference was the number. The number was different. This is the announcement for how long the match is going to be.
一本勝負ですね。一本勝負.
So 一本勝負 is literally one fall. So listen out for that too, because it might be a special match. It might be maybe a three falls match. Maybe. So if you listen out for those. So Koji, let's do some number practice. So one fall.
一本。二本。三本。
Okay, so those are the three you need to listen out for. Now, sometimes during the match, the action will spill out to the outside. Now, this is where you have to really pay attention to the announcer, because the announcer will say,
お気をつけください.
Now, you'll hear that quite a lot, and it literally just means, be careful, or watch out. And you need to be on your toes, because, well, prime example, when I went to the Tokyo Joshi Pro event in Yokohama, the match went to the outside and Maho was throwing Miu into the chairs, and there isn't much time to get out of the way. If you're not ready to grab your bags and get out of the way, your bag is getting crushed. Or you are getting crushed. And it does happen. Be on your toes. When you hear the announcement, please be careful. Get ready to jump out of the way, because it will happen. The next part we're going to take a look at is phrases that you could use with the wrestlers if you get the chance to meet them after the show. Now, I know Japanese is a very difficult language to study, and I know not everyone has the time to even study Japanese. Most people, I think, know basic Japanese, like konnichiwa, hello, okinki desu ka, how are you, you know, this kind of textbook style Japanese. And the wrestlers appreciate it, they really do. If you just say, you know, konnichiwa, hajimemashite, you know, nice to meet you, they feel grateful that you've taken the time to kind of study that. But if you want to take it just to that next level, I've got some good phrases for you that we're going to share with you now, and you can practice the pronunciation. I'm going to get Koji to say it, because obviously Koji's pronunciation is way better than my Japanese. So we'll start off with this phrase.
お疲れ様です.
お疲れ様です. Is literally cheers for the good work, or good job, you know, thanks for the hard work. お疲れ様です. The next phrase you can use.
いい試合でした.
This literally means that was a good match. I means good. 試合, match. でした. It was. So it was a good match. So you can combine those two together. So you can say, お疲れ様でした。いい試合でした。 And another phrase, maybe you will be attending another event, so you might want to use this phrase.
次の試合も頑張ってください。
次の試合も頑張ってください。 So, in your next match, also, please do your best. So, good luck in your next match, basically. But if you combine all of those three together, and you can practice those, and you say those to the wrestlers, their faces will light up. it always makes the wrestlers feel happy to hear foreign fans speaking Japanese as well. Okay, and it's time to wrap up with our regular feature of the show. It's the Wrestler of the Month. So, Koji, who is your Wrestler of the Month?
はい、今月の Wrestler of the Month はザック・セイバー Jr. 選手ですね。はい、先日ニュージャパンカップ新日本プロレスのね、春のトーナメントが行われたわけですが、ザック・セイバージュニア選手が優勝しました。このトーナメントの中では、彼は、まあ、ダークホースの、ポジションであったわけですが、内藤哲也、井口浩太、真田、棚橋宏を撃破して、優勝という形になりました。 ザック・セイバージュニアは、まあ、去年からニュージャパンに、参戦していまして、まあ、彼のサブミッション、関節技、なんですけども、それがまあ非常に素晴らしい。それをまあニュージャパンの今回のトーナメントでよりね、いろいろな関節技を、披露してトップを取ったという形でありまして、まあ日本でいうまあ関節技の達人、
うん、
サブミッションマスター、のね、いうのを、日本のファンの皆様にも、見ていただけたのではないだろうかということで、非常に、楽しかったですね。
うん
うん、いろいろな見て、分かりやすい、関節技の痛さ、辛さ、というのをもう彼の、テクニックがね、存分に出た試合でしたので、彼が今月のレスラーオブマンス、に選びました。
Good choice, yeah. British, イギリス人。My wrestler of the month is Maki Ito.
Ooh.
Maki Ito. Yes. I had the opportunity to meet Maki Ito 2 months ago here.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She had a special event here, and it was her first time in Osaka, right? Mm-hmm. Kind of having an event. And there were lots of fans here, and I was stood like at the back of the room here, just kind of, you know, minding my own business. And she was looking around the room, and she said, "Ah, oh, many people that I don't know, loads of faces that I don't. Ah, Sean-san da!" And I was really shocked that she recognized me from kind of Twitter, obviously doing translations, that kind of thing. So that made me really happy, and I instantly became a Maki fan. Yeah, and then we chatted after the show as well. We talked about her maybe studying English, that type of thing too, what her plans were for the future. But I think her drive for becoming a pro wrestler is admirable. She used to be in a idol group. She switched over from kind of being an idol into being a pro wrestler, which is a bit of a weird career change, but she has really loved getting into this kind of pro wrestling environment. Her character is fantastic because everyone kind of knows that she has this idol background. And she plays up on that. Even her costume is kind of idol style. When she gives her MC like announcements, she will talk about how amazing she is and how great she is and how everyone should support her. Like, she wants everyone to love her. And I think it's safe to say that is actually happening now. Her popularity is slowly increasing. There's actually a Twitter account which takes a lot of Maki Ito's tweets and then translates them into English. I'll put a link in the description below so you can check it out for yourself, because she really is the funniest wrestler, and her reactions that she gives during the matches and in her promotions after the show as well, there's nothing like it. I know GIF makers like Total Divas episodes, they all of these guys, they love making reaction GIFs of Maki Ito's face, and I really think this year, providing that she doesn't sustain any serious injuries, she has the potential to become the next Tokyo Joshi Pro Princess of Princess Champion. This month, we're actually going to do our first ever giveaway competition. It's only a small giveaway, but I guess it's better than nothing, right? What we're going to do is I'm going to give away some Joshi Pro Wrestling trading cards.
Ooh.
I've been collecting these recently, so I wanted to share some of these with you guys. So there's a small stack there. And also, my wrestler of the month, Maki Ito. Ooh. This is Maki Ito's single, and it's also signed from one of the shows when she came to Osaka. So this is your chance to get your hands on this. If you want to be in with the chance of winning these little goodies, what we're going to do, I'm going to post this video on Twitter, and what I want you guys to do is retweet and also comment on the video. That way I can see clearly who has kind of retweeted it and commented on it. And then in the next video, I will choose someone at random from the comments. I'll use one of the kind of random things, and then I'll try and send these to you. And then next month we'll maybe do another giveaway or something. That's everything for today's show. Thank you for checking out the video, and I hope there is some information in here that you can use and is useful for you. Please help by liking and sharing the video as much as you can. And if you know anyone that's coming to Japan, share this video with them, because there might be some information here that they might find useful. See you next time on count. One, two, three.